When we draw on a computer, all we're really doing is assembling an array of colors. If you've ever looked at your computer monitor under a magnifying glass, you've probably noticed that each pixel is actually three vertical rectangles, one red, one green, and one blue. And yet, when you take away the magnifying glass, the pixel can look like any color at all. Pretty weird, right? This works because the human eye isn't as good at distinguishing colors as you might think. Our eyes can't actually tell the exact energy of an incoming photon. So here's our eyeball, and here's the cornea, and here's the retina, and here's the optic nerve. Now the actual sensors in the eye are three types of cone cells. And each of these type of cone cells collects photons of a particular range of wavelengths. If a photon falls in the range of the L, or long wavelength, cone cell, our brain perceives it as red. If the wavelength is a little shorter and it falls into an M, or medium cone cell, then it looks green. And if the photon has a super short wavelength and stimulates the S cone, it appears blue. All other colors are just how our brain interprets photons that stimulate multiple types of cone cells at once. Since red, green, and blue light each directly stimulate one of the types of cone cells, this means we can simulate any other color by replicating how that color would stimulate the cone cells. For instance, the color yellow is the result of stimulating both the L and the M cones. But it doesn't matter to our brain exactly what photons were involved. It could be a yellow laser where every photon has exactly the same energy, or it could be an even combination of green and red light. The response of the L and M cones is the same either way, so to our brain, it's the same color. The unintuitive result is that any visible color can be generated by a combination of red, green, and blue. Human color vision is a crazy topic, and you can check out the instructor notes to learn more.